thanks, Paul. We love being here. This is one of our favorite places. This is a true chamber. This is what chamber music is, right? And you'll hear when we start that the acoustics are just, there's not a seat in this place where you can't hear absolutely everything that we're hearing. And it's wonderful. So anyway, we're glad you're here. We'll try to keep this relatively short so it doesn't get too hot in here. We're going to do two whole pieces for you tonight with an intermission between. We're going to do things in a less conventional order. We're going to start with a Brahms string quartet, the A minor quartet of Brahms, and then we're going to do the fourth quartet of Bartok after the break. Should be fun. The Brahms we've recently recorded, and I had a whole stack of CDs that I was going to bring that you could check out, but I was stressed out because the babysitter hadn't arrived yet, and so that got left there. So, not to be a shameless plugger, but go online and find it. Brahms by heart, Chiara Quartet. Anyway, four movements. I guess all we need to say. Enjoy. We might want to do no AC. I don't know if it's possible. There's still, yeah, it's kind of loud still. I think so. Part we can really, yeah, sorry. Thank you.
Thank you. we get started, I'm curious how many of you have heard Bartok's Fourth String Quartet before? Okay, let's try that again. How many of you have not heard Bartok's Fourth String Quartet before? Okay, so it's about half and half.
Cool.
All right, so this is not Brahms, but it is awesome. And we play it a lot. We love it. And I just wanted to let you know a little bit of what to listen for. Even if you've listened to this 100 times, you may not be aware that Bartok was not just a composer, he was not just a great pianist, he was also one of the first ethnomusicologists. And this fancy word means that he went into remote mountain villages all over Europe and Northern Africa and recorded thousands of hours of folk music on early recording devices. And then he took it a step further, transcribed much of it into Western notation, and then he took it a step further and used some of these tunes in his music. And then he took it a step further and started writing new music that had not existed before that sounded like folk music. And in that way, he invented a new folk music almost for an imagined country where any of us could live. Well, that's all very exciting, especially for those who like analysis and interesting things, but I thought it would be nice to actually hear one of the recordings he made. And thanks to Steve Jobs, that's actually possible. And this is a recording that he made in North Africa, and you'll hear a singer, a drum, and a flute-like instrument. And the reason that I'm playing this particular recording for you is that it connects directly to the quartet we're about to play. So before we talk about that, let's hear it. Pretty amazing, right? At the beginning, this string quartet has 5 movements. At the beginning of the last movement, you'll hear this recording come back in its new imagined form by Bartok. The violins together play the first thing that sounds a bit to me like the flute. And then the drums come into the lower voices. The singer possibly in the 3rd movement. Just thought of that one. Yeah. But everywhere you listen, you can find elements of this folk music. But again, because it's Bartok, he's taking it to another level. And you'll hear things that remind you of 20th century music by composers like Schoenberg, who were shattering the traditions. You'll hear music that reminds you of the bugs outside. You'll hear music that reminds you of a lot of things, but nothing that you've heard before. It's all uniquely Bartok. And the more we play it, the more we love it. Which you can't say for everything. But especially things that the first time you hear it may be completely unfamiliar. And I find that really remarkable. Bartok has taken something that no one else had ever imagined and created something so human. So I hope you enjoy it as much as we do. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. major, opus 20, number 2.